Okay, so 1 hour for the monthly to close, January, August, not January, August 1st. So 1 hour to close. So basically, we hold the 12 here, we hold this support from this candle here. We are holding the 12 as long as we maintain the 12 exponential like this, we are good. So on the monthly, the structure was not broken. We are still in a bull run on the monthly. Only on the weekly and the low time frames, we are in a downtrend. On the monthly, we are still in an uptrend. So I'm basing everything on the monthly, and then after the monthly, I will base my thoughts on the lower time frame. So on the monthly, we are good. Higher low set support will be this candle close. We are trying to close above this week on the previous month's candle and above this week here. Next target will be this candle close and that week. I did this trend line here. This is the one that comes from 2017, so it will be a strong one that was not tested as resistance. But this one, it's a new one that it's with this week, with that week, and I will show on the weekly where we can go. But these are the targets here to make the lower high. Until here, we do a lower high until this candle close here, which will be around here. So if this can take 1 more month, 2 months, and then I think everyone will be bullish, even if we do a fake out and then reassess. I don't know the future, but from what I see, we will come to this area to get some liquidity, put everyone bullish, and then we will have a crash. But until we break this area, everything is fine, and we can be ranging here and go slowly like this. So it doesn't matter what I think, see what the charts are telling you and act. So basically, support will be here now, this candle close, basically. So we can set this one, come down with a wick, test support, even we can come lower. But we need to close the months at least above here, above 37.7, and especially above this candle close now. Of course, we can open the next candle and start keep on going up, but I think we on the daily we are already overbought. So the support basically buy the dip, don't FOMO. If you didn't buy already, just wait, be patient. Buy on the supports on the low time frames. This is the support until here. This candle closes below, it's bearish. Remember, the 21 is going higher, and we can do something like this. We can do something like this, go up, lower high, or like this, until we go to the 21 and the 20 and do something like this. And then let's see if we have enough strength or if something, or we keep on doing lower highs and then we break down. So that's for me, this is what will happen. But even if we come to a higher area, but or like this, until we go to the 21 and the 20, and then maybe we have a pump like this. Put everyone bullish and then we crash. So it's a matter of time that we will have a crash, but doesn't matter. As soon as for now, buy the dips, stop losses below, each one manage their risk and take profits as they want. But for now, support is this candle close. Very simple. And this is the monthly. Okay? So indicators now are pointing up on the monthly. And we can go higher. Weekly. So we are tomorrow, in 24 hours, we have the weekly close. For now, we are still above the 21 and the 12. So this is bullish. You can buy the dip on this moving average on the weekly, plus the monthly, and weekly also on this candle close. So basically, we are now looking for a higher low on the weekly too after tomorrow's close. So we can come down. Remember, liquidity here, for me, this is a target for Bitcoin. We already came to this one, and then this is my next target for Bitcoin. Where is the liquidity? But this can take months, years. Nobody knows when it will come. But liquidity, it's in this area. Of course, we have the 200s here. We'll have bounces on this moving average on the weekly. For me, as I said, this one was tested as support. We didn't test this one as support now. So for me, this is a matter of time for investment. For now, it's just swing trading and good money to be made. So on the weekly, as long as we hold the 50 here, which is going higher as well, we have all these supports that you can buy the dip, but let's see, maybe we don't go below, or we can have weeks, but as long as we maintain the 21 and the 20 and we hold here, it's okay. So you can buy, we have all this area to buy the dips, stop loss is below. Target on the weekly, we have the 20 here, which is on the 45K more or less, and we have the same trend line that was made on the monthly plus this one. But this is the next target, so we can range a little bit here and then maybe liquidate people and then let's see. But keeping it simple with the monthly supports, or you can have the weekly supports, which are these ones here, with the top one being here on the 21. So this is a strong support, which is this candle close, which is the very easy, it's the 39K. Anyway, dips are to buy. So very easy to control risk. Volume is coming on the weekly, slowly. Just use stop losses. Okay, so this is the weekly already pointing up. Resistance will be these areas here. Daily, we are trying to close above those wicks here. But even if we close down, we have support here. So this trend line worked as support. This trend line that I had and I posted it act as support, bounced from there, and now we are already above the 100. But remember, we have the 21, the 20, the 12, so we can go higher. We have 200 here. So this is the kind of the next target, somewhere around this area. It's then a target and the 45. Then I think we will consolidate because we are already pointing down, or we consolidate from now until we go there. So nobody knows. But it's still fine. Remember, stop losses will be below here more or less. You can get positions. If you didn't get it here, you can get when it comes down, we go up, maybe, or we come down. Can get like 5% by 5-10%, and buy biggest bids on the bottoms around this area or this area. We have still some liquidity here, but we already came to this one with this wick. But remember, this is the range, bottom of the new bottom of the range. It's not here anymore. Now the bottom, it's this area here. Stop loss is below. Targets, next target 45. This trend line, and then for me, this is the area, 57, 58. And then let's see if we keep on going up, or if everyone is bullish here, calling the moon, I think we will crash again. Or here, nobody knows. Indicators are already pointing down, but we are in a bullish control zone. So as long as the daily maintains these dots here on the 70, we can touch it and push higher. Okay, so everything looks good. Market makers, all the media now is bullish. So just keep the bullish momentum. Just use stop losses by the dips and keep it simple. Don't overthink. So this is where we are, 4 hours, still holding the 12. We bounced exactly from that trend line I have here. Perfect TA. So, but we have these areas for the future. So just be patient if you didn't buy before. Remember, we pumped from this area when everyone is bearish, when everyone was calling 20Ks and down. Remember, descending wedge, a big one, a small one, bounced. We bounced from the monthly week support. We also had this monthly support here. And then We just tested every support on the daily, tested here, 50. This area wasn't tested as support, so remember, in the future we can come to test these areas or here. But this one was tested, so we didn't test this one. Okay, so remember, when everything goes like this, we can have Bitcoin can move and chop. So just buy the low areas, the supports on the monthly and the weekly. Okay, so we are trying to close above this weekly and monthly support, and then we reassess. Next targets will be here and the trend line. Okay, I think that's it. So it's all a matter of patience. Buy the dips. Back to the monthly. So this is where we are. Remember, Ethereum looking good. So this is quite simple, as long as we maintain our ear. Here we can still come here to test support. Remember, we still didn't close. We will close the monthly below the previous candle. So this can be a bearish retest. Don't be so bullish. This can be a bearish retest. Of course, it can come higher, but we close below. We can have a week and then maybe back down. This is a trend line that we can have a good bounce from here in the future, which is made from here, but and we have the moving average. So remember, as long as we maintain this, actually this was really mathematical. Three candle closes on the same spot, big liquidity below. So remember, careful, because many stop losses will be here. Many stop losses will be here as well. So just be careful, use your stop loss as well, manage your risk. And it closes above here, more bullish, but until we pass here, it's just lower highs. And the candle close, we are still below. So this one we won't close above, so it's a lower high. So be careful. Just weekly. This is where the big liquidity is and was. And here it's there. So we will go there, and then for a lower high, everyone calling the moon, and then let's see if we keep on pushing higher or we break down. The 200s are here, big liquidity pool here. So remember, the stock market will also come down sooner or later. For now, let it rise. It's going up until it makes breaks market structure. It's fine, just buy the dips, use your stop loss. Yeah, the market will tell you when we go down. So let's see where we are on the alts, very fast, Litecoin. So above the 12, but still we didn't pass at least this area. Remember, next target will be here. Next target will be there. This can be a bearish retest, and we come here to this area here, to this candle close, which are big resistances here, and we can come down to test 21 to 20. But remember how Litecoin works. Big moves up, we can have another big move up like this one. This is what's happening. But we need to make higher highs. Until we don't do any higher highs, until here, for instance, it's a lower high, but still good profits to be made. So stop losses below here, buy the dips until here, and you can get a small position here, like 5%, big positions here, stop loss maybe below this candle close here or this week here, because of this moving average, and you get leave bits to buy until here and be patient. Then we have these trend lines for the future. If we have a massive crash, remember, Litecoin comes down to the basis, and the bases are here. It's a matter of patience. So So don't be so bullish. You'll see all the media bullish, but remember, look at the chart. Dot, we are still below this area and this area. So nice week. Stop losses below here, each one their own or below this one. But remember, it's a good move, but we need to close above here to be more bullish. So anything under here and under here, it's on the monthly just lower highs. So remember, this can be bearish retests. We need to start closing above this one and then above that one. If you want to buy, stop loss below here, here or here or here, and take the risk. Cardano still on the range, so still lower high. We need to close above, so many buys, very methodical here, but close the month below these weeks, and but we are closing above this support. If we do a line here, so as long as we maintain this, it's fine. But it will depend on Bitcoin. But so we are in a big range from this top to the bottom. So the buys are from the bottom, the sells are from here to there, or the take profits. But remember, we still didn't touch the 12, the 21, and the 20, and this area here. So still ranging, and we didn't close above here. So everything will be the same. Just making lower highs, good bounces, but let's see. Actually, we did that week. We are trying to close above. We have this trend line here. Remember, buys and the 12 is here, so the buys will be on the bottom here. If you want to take a chance, buy a little bit to try to sell, take profits here or above. You can buy a little bit. Support it's here on the monthly. So we are in this range now, trying to close above that one. Let's see where we are. Closed above, so looks bullish. We will come here at least. And this is where is the liquidity. So we should come here sooner or later. Buys around here, this trend line. But we should hold here, range. We don't know. When we crash, we will come to these areas because we went all this way up. You can be here, do a lower high, then let's see. If it closes above here, we'll be bullish. If we don't pass this area here for a monthly lower high, we will come then sooner or later back down big time. Of course, we can bounce on this area, we can bounce on this area again. Indicators are pointing up for now. I see this area. BNB is a strong one, but when it has volatility, we can have big weeks down, you can have big crashes. So okay, I think that's it. Everything will be the same, link, matic. So we came to test the 12 here, the liquidity, here we go, here it is, we were here, all the support, we came for the liquidity here, and we have the 200. Next targets will be here. Let's see if we pass through this zone, otherwise we will come down, test these supports on the trend lines. Remember volatility, but still lower low, lower high. Okay, Matic the same. Next target will be here on the moving average. As long as we maintain the 21 and the 20, stop loss is below. But remember, we can have volatility, big spikes, so be careful. Supports will be here and here. This is the area of support. This is a big range. Let's see if it holds this range to push there. And then let's see when Bitcoin touches the 20, when it corrects. Let's see what happens here. But still, we need lots of energy to start to close at least above here and to hold time highs. But 21 and the 12 and the 20 are to buy. The buys are here. So from the 12, 21. So the stop losses will be here. Target will be the 100K. Again, closes above here, we can go next target. Okay. ZRX also very good. The ones that didn't pump, so I bought it. I will take profits here. My stop losses are here. If we come down, I'm out. I will take profits. This is just for some trades. This is my target. But I bought ZRX when I said, and I have EOS a little bit. My stop loss is below this trend line, basically. It's below this trend line, basically. Come on. So my stop loss is here. I already bought. I have more bids until this trend line. I'm out if we go below this trend line. When Bitcoin we can might come here, maybe just do something like this and then let's see. There's some liquidity here, but we might not pass this area, but from here to here some good profits are to be made. So I'm in these two positions. I'm out if we go below. Okay. So 40 minutes, so I know, okay, still good. Trying to close above this support here. Okay, so remember monthly and weekly, monthly close today, higher low set, weekly closing tomorrow. Nice bounce, we will look for a higher low. Maybe until here. We can still pump until there, find a higher low on the moving averages or with weeks, possible weeks below, fake outs, and we can range a bit more on this area. Remember, stop losses below this area and buy the dips. Very easy for risk management. Okay.